I feel like I'm talking to members of one of the royal families of Hollywood's golden age, because this film is just so perennial. Jimmy Hawkins, Carolyn Grimes, how are we today?
Great, thank you.
Wonderful. Excellent. Wonderful.
Wonderful.
You like that word?
That's a perfect choice, Carolyn. That's brilliant. Right off the bat, Carolyn, do you think Zuzu Bailey must be arguably the most memorable character name in all of cinematic history? Would you agree with that?
I would agree with that. Do you know where she got her name?
No, where?
When George comes back from his unborn sequence, he runs up the stairs and I come out my door and I say, "Daddy, Daddy." And he says, "Zuzu, my little ginger snap." So I was named after a cookie.
Oh.
It was made by the National Biscuit Company and it was called Zuzu's Ginger Snaps.
That's adorable. Well, how fitting too, because you were so cute. You were six at the time. And, you know, you're put on set with arguably the most fatherly man in America, and certainly became kind of America's father, or at least avuncular, and the beautiful Donna Reed as well. What do you remember about those two as parents on the set?
Well, of course, Jimmy Stewart was 6 feet four. He was incredibly tall. And that I'll never forget, because I'm up on his arms or on his shoulders, and I mean, he was just there. He was very kind and gentle, and he took time with me. And if I messed up a line, he helped me through that. He just was a good person. I have to tell you, though, the only time I was around Donna Reed was at the end of the movie. And granted, she was standing next to me, but I don't remember her at all. I was all about him.
Jimmy, you were four and a half when you had the role of Tommy, but at that point, you were already a seasoned pro. You had worked with Hepburn, Tracy, I think Lana Turner as well. That's just amazing before, you know, your fifth birthday, just the stars that you had worked with. But you said you have some pretty vivid memories of Frank Capra. So I want to know about this legendary director and what you remember about that.
Well, he's very patient with us kids. Especially when we come out of the living room, we're going into the kitchen scene and all the actors are going that way. And so he, you know, action, let's see what you are going to do. And then he'd stop everybody, Jimmy Stewart, Donna Reed. And then he came over to me and he squatted down and talked to me eye to eye and said, "Here's what I want you to do. See where you are right now?" "Yes, sir." "You see right here?" "Yes." "Well, I want you to keep pulling on this man's coattail. And when you get here, say the word, 'excuse me.' You understand that?" I said, "Yes, sir, I do." "Okay, everybody, let's keep going." So we went to the next place and the next place. And each place, he'd squat down, told me to remember right here, when you get here, this is when you say, "excuse me" again. So he was very patient, very nice, always giving business. When Jimmy Stewart comes into the room the first time, I'm going through his pockets. I'm putting tinsel on his head. I'm carpet sweeping the floor when he tells me, "Stop that, stop that." You know, always business. Capra would capture that. And he told me that that's the most difficult scene to direct in the whole movie, was that scene with the family. He's pounding the piano. He's asked, "How do you spell this? You're going, 'excuse me.'" And, oh, it's just chaos going on. And he said it could have been laughable. They'd laugh at it, not with it. So he said that was the most difficult scene to direct. And I think it turned out like a real family. You just felt that you were kind of watching this family and nothing was phony or nothing for him to worry about. But he worried and he had to balance all that. And that's why he was a great director.
We and 100% does it feel like a real family. It really does just translate on screen.
People, they just love that family.
Yeah.
There are people that have much bigger parts than us or anything, but that Bailey family means so much to people. Carol and I have talked about that. I said, "Isn't that something? They'd just rather see us than maybe somebody else in this movie." And that's because that Bailey family is America.
Let's talk about that scene specifically, because there is such great realism to it. And two things kind of translate, I think, at the end of the movie. And like you said, you're kind of picked up by Jimmy. And, you know, that the joy of everybody singing is clearly in the room. And Jimmy, I wanted to talk about the time, like you just said, where you're putting the tinsel on Jimmy Stewart's head and he holds you so tight. I mean, it's a gorgeous scene. Do you guys remember, if not so much the vivid memories, just the feeling or the emotion of the room or those scenes? Were you actually reacting to that?
You are. It's through osmosis. Because you know that this is, you don't know these people, and the director has to tell you who they are and what your association is. You go, oh, okay, I get it. They brought us in on a Saturday morning to do that scene, and they picked up the close-ups. Capra didn't even direct that scene. They brought in another director on that Saturday to do all those close-ups, and he would talk to us. And he said, now your daddy's over here, and he's doing this and that. And he got a performance out of each one of us. He explained it and took time to do that. And you go, wow, that all those close-ups were Capra's out directing something else. Isn't that something? Wow.
Carolyn, if I can just add one little more thing to that, just again, not only do you have the most memorable name probably in cinematic history, but you have one line of dialogue that's up there with, you know, frankly, Scarlett, I don't give a damn. Like, everybody knows that quote. I want to know, because I've heard this through the internet, and you never know what's true. You actually have the ornament, the ornament from the tree in Every Time a Bell Rings. Is that true? Do you still have that ornament?
Well, I was an only child, and my father didn't make very much money, so we had a little tiny Christmas tree on a table. And so I was pretty infatuated with that giant Christmas tree on the stage. Oh my goodness, it was beautiful, and the ornaments were gorgeous, and there might be one missing.
I'm pretty sure they maybe haven't noticed by now. I think you can keep it. Yeah, you might be okay. We've talked about some of my favorite moments. What's your favorite moment from this movie? Carolyn, let's start with you.
Well, my favorite scene is where George is on the bridge and he wants to live again. And he says, Clarence, Clarence, I want to live again. And he says, please, God, I want to live again. And then as soon as he says the word God, it starts to snow. And you know he's back. And he's discovered what really is important in life. And I think it's faith and family and friends. And I think maybe a lot of people believe that it could be miracles as well. So that's my favorite scene, because it's so meaningful. He loves his life. Yeah. And he realizes that. And so he wants to go back.
I love it. And Jimmy, what about yours?
My favorite scene is the scene on the telephone. You can just see the electricity in that scene of these two people. You know, all the meetings they had when they were little kids in the drugstore, to her at the dance and falling in the pool. And then that's all she wanted. She always loved George Bailey. And you know that moment. They both came together. They wanted each other. He just had dreams of other things that she didn't fit into, but she really did fit into. And I love that scene. And when it was over, Jimmy Stewart didn't want to do that. He kept putting it off for weeks. And then Capra said, we're doing it now. You know, it's two lips, they're kissing, let's do it. So they did do it. They did it in one take. And he yelled, cut, print. And the script girl said, Mr. Capra, they missed a whole page of dialogue. He said, you don't need words. And he said, print it. And he said he got the scene he wanted.
Wow.
You know, and it was. It was great, yeah. In my opinion.
Yeah, I got chills when you were both describing both of those scenes, because it's just so palpable.
Yeah.
You're absolutely right. Well, I'm in Canada right now. I'm outside of Toronto, and I'm, you know, we just call this early November, but soon enough, I do want to say happy holidays to you and yours. I look forward to watching it on TV once again. And thanks so much for taking the time to do this.
Thank you, and Merry Christmas.
Okay, best to you.
Merry Christmas.
All right.
Hey, Real students, thanks for watching. If you want to subscribe to Real School, click that round Real School logo right beside me. Also, click that damn notification bell so you're aware of all of Real School's new content. You can follow me on Twitter, and of course, if you get anything out of Real School, you can always give a little back. Just click the link in the description below or the button down there, and you can become part of my Patreon team.